So, while the players can see what we see now is all the players that is not clicked on blue is not online as yet. So basically for Saturday, I think we're just going to try and follow a similar process for the first couple of minutes for the first round, where we just want to give everyone an opportunity to join the tournament and make sure everyone is ready. But I think we will limit it to like 5 minutes on Saturday. So if anyone is not locked in and ready by within 5 minutes, then we will do the pairings and start. Otherwise, we are going to run late. So what will happen then, we will just withdraw the people, and if they are ready, then we can make them or unwithdraw them, whatever the right word is for that.
Maybe redraw.
No, I don't want to redraw them because so what happens if you look there, let's see what happens here. So he is like withdraw for the first round, but then we will withdraw them, and I think they've got the unwithdraw is the verb what is used by the system. Okay, but so basically what I will do is I will do a start now. There's a manual pair where I can manually pair, or I will start now and the draw will become available. I will immediately change it. You will see on the left here it's going to live. I will change it immediately to draft. So players, please don't start playing when you see, because we just want to get the arbiters on as well. There will be a button available for call arbiter. So that is as if you were in the on the over the board tournament. Is anything that you would need an arbiter's assistance, then you will have to call an arbiter. But in a real tournament, you will have to type for us. You will not allow to talk. So we understand it's a little bit difficult for a smaller players, but please, if you want to call the arbiter, feel free, and then one of the arbiters will attend to you. Okay, so is he actually going to play then?
He is in. He is clicked
So
ready.
let me just put him back.
Okay. Can't spell.
Why is my Tornello unstable? Let it just save. Okay. So I'm just going to do the pairing. Okay, Orbiter, I hope you watch.
Ronel, are we not supposed to refresh before we pair, or is it not necessary?
That's fine.
After we
No,
make changes.
normally you will, but that's fine. Yeah, no, but that's fine. So I'm just going to change this quickly to draft. So players, you can quickly check your opponents and see. Is that good? Okay, now I'm going to keep mine shared for the arbiter's sake, but for Saturday we won't share, okay? Now I'm going to publish the pairings. And players, you should hear a sound now and it should tell you that you should become ready. And I'm going to start the round so you can start playing. Okay, so arbiters, please go to the lobby. Open up a second page on the lobby and watch for the arbiters' calls.
What are we supposed to do after we've completed our game?
Once you've completed, then you must just wait. So don't log out. So keep keep going. Keep it. Okay, so I'm still sharing. So I just want the players also to see. So from an orbiter's perspective, you see, you would have gone to the table now to put in your score. And this is now the score is automatically captured on your behalf. So we can see here which tables are still playing. I'm doing this on purpose so that you guys can see what the arbiters see and that, yes, everything is under control at this stage.
And so you don't have to worry about sending in the scores. So the last game is done.
Okay, so arbiters, if you refresh your screen now, you should see results for all games. Okay, so Renee. So just before you do the draw, I just want to speak to the players quickly. And maybe if there are parents around. So I just want to make you aware of the fair play report that the arbiters, that is made automatically available to the arbiters. So Tornello has built-in capabilities where it checks everything on the fly for any cheating and so. So as soon as my event is just coming up, I think I've just got a lot open at the moment.
Now, can I pair the next round so long?
No, don't pair yet. I just want to show them. Can you get to the fair play report? Okay, so players, I just want to show you. So over here, it's on the arbiters dashboard. It's not available to players, but it's available to the arbiters. It's a tournament report. And I just want to show you what it looks like so that you get an understanding of what they are looking at. So on the fair play report is what most of you know on lead chess is the center pawn loss on this column. And then there's a move match. And center pawn just means how well you play and so, but move match also indicate the percentage that you move according to the book. Okay. So the higher this percentage, then the more chance there is in combination with your center point loss and everything that there is a possibility of cheating. But we will keep from an arbiter's perspective an eye on this. Obviously, in the higher sections, like your A section, you are going to get very low CPLs and high MMs because the players obviously has a lot more knowledge already. But if we get this type of behavior in the lower sections, then there might be a problem. Okay. So, but from an arbiter's perspective, we've got now built-in tools that can assist us with this. And yes, we will use it as and when required. But yeah, we're not going to share necessary this information with the players. So if you suspect that there's a player that your opponent is cheating, then we might not make this available to you. But yes, we will look into it and say, yes, either the player is just playing very good today and request him to play on Zoom and you playing on Zoom, but we will not just make accusations from this report. There is from the owners of the system capabilities where we can pay a fee to have detailed there. But if you then want to put a formal complaint in, we will most probably ask you to pay the fee. Okay, so, but I just wanted you to know about it. Okay, thanks. Okay, Renee, if you are in the lobby, and click on around here, then you could get an overall view of all the clocks for all the players. The green next to the players indicate that they are online. If they are not online, it will be red. Okay, and you also see the move counter. Okay, I think all the games are complete. just before you do the draw, Renee, I just want to put a player on the board that I'm showing at the moment. So that is the results as they came in. I also just want to make you aware, on the same board, if any player is going to log in more than once, there will be a column appearing on this sheet where the arbiter can see that the player has multiple logins or multiple times that he has logged in on Tornello, which might also be an indication that he is making use of or something. Someone else might be playing on his behalf or something. Okay, so there are all sorts of tools available to the arbiters in Tornello. Hence, that's the platform that we've decided to